trying a new external mic. It's a Rode stereo mic. I got it put on the outside of the tractor. We got some snow last night. Actually, we had a storm. We had about 15, 20 centimeters. It was cold. I think at one point it was minus 20 degrees with the heat, 20 degrees Celsius. So there's going to be places with the wind, there's going to be places where there's lots of snow. There's going to be places where there's not much snow. I went out early this morning and I did some snow clearing or blowing some snow with the Honda snow blower for the pads for Kathy. So she's there cleaning up now. So I figured I'd put the mic on the outside of the tractor, let you hear the sounds of the tractor. And then maybe three parts through, I'll probably put it in the cab and see what it sounds like in then. Kind of an experiment. People are always asking for snow clearing videos. I don't know why, but anyway, for our friends who want one, this is it. Thank you. Okay, folks, I got you back inside the cab here now, because we have some friends of ours and some viewers in Australia and New Zealand, our buddy Jake there in Florida, there's ever so many, and they just can't stand the cold. So I didn't want to leave you out there for too long. So we'll finish it up here as we're going with the mic in the cab. Hopefully the sound quality is okay. As you can see, there's a lot of snow down. So what I'm going to do here now is I'm going to go ahead and blow the snow over in the middle of the lawn there. That way I don't have to pile it up so much down at the end of the road or on where you see that other pile there. I'll try to minimize it because we don't know how much more snow we're going to get. So I'll be back in a minute. Okay, I never put the camera in the back this time, so you'll have to bear with me. We're cutting the path with the snowblower here now. And it's working quite well, as you can see. Hear a little thump on the mic because the lever striking it where I got to use the snowblower. You can move a lot of snow with the snowblower. But I still prefer the blade. It's really fast with the blade. People say, well, how come you don't have a front mount snow blower? Well, you can tell by the way I do my snow clearing, the front blade would, or front snow blower wouldn't be much good to me. Said I'd stop doing snow clearing videos because I figured everybody'd be sick of them, but every now and then I get an email, when are you going to do another snow clearing video? So that's why I'm doing them. That'll take care of the snow blowing. Makes life a lot easier, I'll tell you. I'm just gonna blow what's left out in the chute. Okay. I think that's it. Yep, that's it. Okay. You'll notice that I was plowing snow quite fast. Well, I got a tendency to listen to music, and depending on how upbeat the music is, depends on how fast I plow, to be honest with you. So now you can see the reason why I use the snow blower, or the blow snower, I like to call it. stuff on the blade a little bit, and that allows me to have good steering control. A lot of newbies at tractors say, well, I got my blade down, I can't steer it, because what happens is when you put your blade right down on the ground and you put it in the float position, and the float position being right down like that, well, then you're light in the front end, so it's hard to steer. So I like to lift it up a little bit. Just lift it up to the point where you're still scraping your driveway, but you still got your wheels firmly planted on the ground. There's the road truck going up there with the salt, as you can see. Those of us who are fortunate enough to have a tractor, we're lucky. Because I certainly wouldn't want to plow this now with just a regular snowblower. It's very warm here in the cab. And when I'm not taping, I'll have music on. It's a really nice sound. Better audio, so again, I don't know if this is going to work. I'll let you guys be the judge of that. And it's Valentine's Day, so I got up early. I got up 7:30 and decided, well, I'll get the snow clearing done. We'll take Kathy to the city for a nice meal and take her out for some shopping. Let her go right to it. Turn on my reverse beeper, backup beeper. Going by the road, and I'll turn on some more lights. So as you can see, the Department of Highways trucks are going again. So that fella's coming back. So I'm gonna move in out of here so he don't spray me full of salt. Somebody asked me how I keep the tractor so clean. That's one of the tricks, my friends. We'll watch and see if I can get you a better view. Here he goes. Thank you. so I'm backing in the snow there. Now that's waist deep, so take me a little while to sort it out here. Usually what I'll do then is if it gets too piled up down here, I'll go and get the late material bucket, or some people call them a snow bucket, and then I'll pull the snow out of here. Makes it safe for our customers and, of course, ourselves getting out on the road. Ago, so that's why it seems on a bit of a tilt there. Have a look down in the back and see what's going on. Well, I haven't seen down there yet. People ask me why I don't use a snow pusher in the front. Well, this is why. Because I like to be able to angle to get in around places. And the snow pusher won't allow me to do that. I find this much more convenient than, in this case, much more efficient. Snow pushers are great on parking lots, straight pushes. This way now. Thank you. crushed down in the snow, guys. Look. That's why I don't like to push it out over the bank. And then up here, you can see where I did the snow blowing with the Honda snow blower. And I just basically cut the paths across around the buildings. Supposed to have rain next week, so if you don't clean it up good now, you'll probably never get it cleaned up the winter, because it'll start to rain and then it'll freeze. You won't be able to do anything with it then. At least this way I can walk down around here if I need to. Not that I need to, but it is what it is. Snow clearing is nice when it's just like this, but boy, I'm gonna tell you, if I had to do it commercially now, I think I'd throw up. Even by the time I get this done, I'll have my full of it, as they say. But I spent a lifetime at it, on heavy equipment as well, so I guess it's a little different for somebody who did it for a living. Those of you out there who's done it for a living, absolutely understand what I'm saying. Have the grade on the property down here, the water ends up draining out here, so I'll always push this across here. And if we get a lot of rain, it will find its place, which is the lowest point here. A few rocks and a few stumps there, which I got to clean up this summer. Clean this up a bit better. Little maple tree here. I keep forgetting about them. We planted them. We planted them last summer. Well, I don't think he's cracked off, but didn't do him much good. Trees are great, but they're a real hindrance when you're trying to do snow clearing. Especially small trees, because you don't really know where they are. But they'll be relocated again in the summer, because we got to widen that out there. We got to get our property line established. And we own another, I guess, 15 feet that way. Where those trees are. See what I mean about lifting your FEL up, your front end loader or your bucket up or your blade up a little bit when she's down. It enabled me to have better steering control. What do you think? That's a bit of snow for you, eh? And I'll remotely open the garage door. So what I'll do now is I'll let the tractor have a 2 or 3 minute cool down so the turbo can cool and lube up. And it is 25 after 10. I've been on the go since 7:30. So we're gonna go in and have our brekkie, do some editing. Hopefully the sound is okay. And we'll see you the next time around. So. Man, I don't know if anybody wants to see any more snow clearing videos after this one. There's only so much I can show you. But anyway, here it is. It is what it is. So, we'll have to try to come up with something else. So that's it, folks. Like I say, it's Valentine's Day, so take your lovely out for a meal or whatever. I'm sure he or she will enjoy it. Mostly for she's, I think. Yeah. Man, I don't remember getting anything for Valentine's Day, only sarcasm. Nah, I'm only kidding. Anyway, folks, you guys have a good one. You take care, and God bless.